You can touch a life, and that life gets touched, and that life touches another life, and then that, and it goes on. Amen?
Amen.
Our God, I thank you. We have Luke chapter 22, verse 32. Bless the Lord. It says, let me go to verse 31. Simon, Simon, behold, Satan hath desired to have you that he may sift you as wheat. But I pray for thee that thy faith fail not, and when thou art what? Converted, strengthen thy brethren. When I looked up the word converted, it means change or to turn. This is what the whole mission is. God is touching our lives so we can touch other lives. Amen. Your spirit may just be your home. Your spirit may be your office. Your spirit may be wherever God wants you to be. But however, he's going to let you touch lives somewhere, somehow. Tell somebody, when you've been converted, strengthen your brother. He says that when you have turned, when you have changed, when Satan has desired to have you, that he may sit you as wheat, and I pray for you. He didn't say, I pray for you that you wouldn't go through it. He didn't say, I pray for you that you would have devil rebuke and power. He didn't say, I pray for you to do all these things. He said, I pray that your faith will still be intact when it's all over. That when the devil beats you down over your head and you're down to the ground, that you can still get back up and say, glory to God. And now that I've been through what I've been through, I'm going to go help somebody else that has been through the same thing. Tell somebody, converted. See, it's about change. It's about turning. It's about being different. Amen. What he does. That's what he does when we're in spiritual boot camp. He's getting us changed. He's getting us different. Amen. So that you notice when you see people who go into service, when they come out, they look completely different.
Wow.
They don't look like the same person, they don't act like the same person, they don't talk like the same person. They've been changed.
Yeah.
Because they've been through boot camp. Amen.
Amen.
They don't have on the same stuff. They come out with their garb on.
Come on.
Face is shaven. They walk it straight. We need to talk that slang and be like, what's up, dog? Now they're saying, good morning, how are you, man?
Nice to see you.
How you doing, my brother? Nice to see you, man. Because they went through boot camp. They went through boot camp. Hallelujah. And they came out successful. Because if they didn't make it through boot camp, they would have never made it on the other side. Tell somebody you need to make it to the other side. See, some of us are still stuck in boot camp, Brother Dennis. Some of us are still going through the same stuff over and over, going through the same course, Minister Corey, over and over and over and over again. I just cannot get over this fighting stuff, man. And I gotta keep going over and over and over and over again. Stuck in boot camp. I can't get this forgiveness thing now. Going over and over and over again. Hate yourself. Hating other people. Going through the stuck in boot camp. Keep going through the same stuff over and over and over again. Somebody hurt you years ago and you're still rehearsing your pain. Still going through it over and over. Every time you see them, you get the same stuff. Here they get. I can't stand them. You know what they did to me? When God is saying, I'm at the end of boot camp, standing here waiting for you to come out so I can make you better and not bitter, to heal you, to deliver you, to set you free, and you're stuck in yourself. Tell somebody, get out of yourself. Well, Pastor Mason, does that mean that what I went through wasn't significant and didn't mean anything? It did. Because it was significant to you. It hurt you. But the thing is, your God is a healer. And that's something he wants to reach in so he can move you to the next step. Amen. So somebody boot camp. He says that when you are converted, when you change, when you turn around, he wants you to begin to strengthen your brother. But we can't get stuck in boot camp with our old ways and our old things and our old thoughts. Those things have to change. God, how I feel. God, I just can't change how I feel about this thing, God. And God is like, look, I'm trying to change all that because what I've got for you is better. God, I'm scared. I have trust issues, God. I want to trust you, God, but I find it hard. Going through the same thing over. If you can't trust God, you can't trust nobody. Let me tell you something about God. He is the one constant source in your life that you can trust. The Bible says that he does not change. He is the same Jesus Christ, the same
yesterday,
today, and forevermore.
Hallelujah.
Now that's not changing, isn't it, Brother Dennis? You ain't changing. You the same yesterday, even though you know you said it's just the same person as they was. They're just gonna always be that way. I think God is that way. Because that means his love didn't change for me. While you're in boot camp, love is pushing you in boot camp. Love is saying, you know what, you have these things that you have inside of you, and I'm going to use you, and I'm going to bless you. However, I need to get you into the boot camp because I need to take some things out that are not good for you. Amen? Praise God. And see, the one thing about boot camp also is that when they go to boot camp, they usually take them far away. Far away from everything, friends, family. So grandma can't come bring you no sandwich at lunchtime. Here you go, baby. You look like you hungry. Here, take your hide in your bag. Amen. They take everything. They take your cell phones. They take everything. Your clothes, everything. So you can't call your boo when you're feeling lonely. Hey, baby, how you doing? I sure do miss you. Yeah. They take you so far away you can't get no quickies. Did I say that, Brother Dennis? Amen. They take you so far away that you can't get to the things that you normally use to comfort and to cover your sins. That's what God does. God takes you far away in the spirit. That the things that you used to do don't feel good anymore. You know? Huh? The things you used to do just don't seem good anymore, you know? Sometimes when you got that gin and that gin and juice, and now it don't taste the same. Nasty now. Huh? You know, the interesting thing is I feel like, man, I can't even hate anymore. I feel like I want to forgive him, but I don't want to. But I feel like I need to.
Yeah, you don't want to.
I feel fear leaving me. But I want to stay in fear. I feel these things changing me. I'm far away from everything. You know how you just be in the middle and all of a sudden God is changing your life and you really don't want to be changed? But he's changing your life because all you did was gave him something to work with. And now all of a sudden the process is on and everything is different now. Amen. Hallelujah. The friends that you hung out with that were so wonderful or so good, now all of a sudden you don't even have an interest to be with them anymore. Now you're looking at your caller ID going, you're in boot camp. You're being changed. You're being changed. Hallelujah. When you're in spiritual boot camp, change is vital.
That's right.
Changes. You have to change because if you don't change, you can't tell somebody else they need to change.
Right.
We have some of the most awesome church professionals out there in the world.